So you're gonna kayak a bait out right now, right?
I'm gonna kayak a bait out here at Sebastian Inlet on the slack tide. It's a bit sketchy, but I think I can do it.
What are we hoping to catch?
Three or 400 pound bull shark that regularly cruises this inlet.
Did you hear that?
Kayaking. I was a wilderness guy in the Florida Everglades. Don't do this. Well, at least a year or 2 years of experience on dangerous water.
Huge redfish on it now.
Drew it alive. Hey, how big got in there? At least 15.
Oh my gosh, Jeff. You're gonna grab him, Jeff?
You wanna get him?
Yeah, you're gonna have to grab him.
It's huge, man.
It's huge.
Fish, don't let fish. Got him, Jeff? There you go.
Shark, just playing.
Dude, that was a big ass shark.
How the hell did the line pop? Did it pop in here?
No. The knot popped, man.
The knot could not have popped because you were already in the braid. And he wasn't spooning you, man. He's got 600 yards of that braid.
That was a big shark.
That
dude.
Was a big shark, but he was stopping.
I didn't want him to get over the mono.
The reason we lost that fish, okay, is because everyone was doing their own thing.
Yeah.
Okay? I'm pissed too. Alright, all that was just bad timing, okay? But you know what? That took 10 minutes to hook a fish that could peel drag on an 80 wide like it was nothing.
All I saw was that line disappearing from that reel a mile a minute. It was already down in the braid.
I
just looks are deceiving me. It looked like there was very little braid on there. That's why I was starting to panic.
There's a lot of braid on
there. I haven't ever used a reel that size. I wasn't sure how to adjust the drag on it. I'm used to fishing 10 centimeters. It just kept going. Kept going. Wouldn't stop.
To see more intense fishing action, click on one of these videos. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.